Fair enough. There we go. All right. Now. I'm sorry, what did you do there? Don't do that. Yeah, there we go. Get up. Hey. Okay. You know what? I'm also gonna do... I guess I could do it from here. Should have done that the other way, but whatever. Now that I have more fuel, I think I'll just go this way. Because I've done this one before, and I know it's doable. Actually, from here, I might go like this, and then like that. Okay. Oh, cool. I do have alerts, I just don't have follows. And actually, I don't think it notifies me about follows unless I have follower alert up. But hey, thanks, man. Appreciate it. Yeah, I found that some people don't like to follow if their name gets put on screen. Because they want to follow, but they don't want, like... They don't want the streamer to be all like, hey! Calling them out and stuff. Yeah, exactly. That's also why when people gift subs to, like, Anonymous, I usually just say thanks for the gift subs, and I don't say thanks for gifting this person with a sub. Like, I don't know if they want to be called out or not. But I'm gonna call you out if you gift subs. It's all like, well, if you didn't want your name called out, you shouldn't have spent money. Let's hope I can make this delivery. I want to see what this building will give me. It'll probably let me buy, like, fuel. And not, like, well, maybe to refill my own truck, but, like, probably also, like, fuel barrels, I would think. Lurkers are the lifeblood of Twitch? Hell yeah, man. Most of my subscribers now are previous lurkers. I even have subs that are just like, hey, I subbed, but I'm never gonna talk here. And I'm all like, alright. Don't bother me none.
As long as you keep paying me money.
You imagine? There are people like that, though. That's sad. They're like, I'm not gonna interact with you unless you're paying me money. And I'm like, such a dick move. I don't know. I've seen some really big streamers with like 3,000-5,000 viewers, and they're interacting with just normal chat all the time. Like, they can't, they obviously can't see everything everybody says, but they try. They at least don't ignore people. Intentionally. You hate those streams? What, you hate streams with lots of people in them? Or streams where... I'm confused. Really? I don't have a problem with it. But to each their own, I guess. Once it gets too active, you avoid it. Fair enough. For me, I avoid busy streams in which the streamer completely ignores people. The streamer's trying to interact with his community, it doesn't bother me. But then again, you do have like lots of alerts on screen and stuff like that, so that can get annoying sometimes. It's also kind of a bummer when if I'm streaming a lot and I have a bunch of viewers but nobody wants to chat because nobody else is chatting, and then I'm all like, man, I want to interact with you guys, but it's just like, I'll have like 12 or 15 viewers and all of them are lurkers, and then I feel like I'm not interacting with chat. Hey, we did it. Track.
Want to learn how to drive with our talented drivers? We hold the clinic on the first Saturday of every month, right here at the track. Sign up at the box office today and learn to burn up the track like a pro.
Yeah, okay. So now, okay, so that's what this is. It's just a gas station. Okay. I wasn't sure what this was. Service hub, that'll be like... refueling station. I guess I didn't really need another refueling station, but... too late!
Our drivers may not have fancy endorsements...
solar panels!
They are world-class athletes.
Three medium planks delivered to the construction crew. Alright, well, this truck doesn't do me any good out here. So let's recover you. Also, this truck... okay, let's recover him. And then... we'll recover you. You're not attached, are you? No. You were empty. Alright, let us... Lettuce. Thank you. I want to drive out here to that, so take a look at that. That's a tunnel to nowhere, because there's no extra map here. This probably connects there, so that makes sense. Let's go here and see if there's a road that comes out this way, because I'm thinking this connects to something. We need to, like, scope out the rest of this map a little bit. Getting all of the side tasks done is really handy, because it usually fixes bridges, opens up new buildings. Stuff that could really help the main missions progress a little faster. Okay, so we'll come over here, then go this way, see where that takes us. Aha! It's all lit up. Definitely something out here. We got out here. It's just like a little swamp area. Okay. See where this takes me. I wonder if this somehow like loops back around over to this. I don't know why you would come out here. Maybe there's something useful in this area. Let's come take a look. More race course. Oh, yeah, there's definitely something back there. Awesome. I wonder if the Tataran would do okay through here. Probably. Okay, there's even more stuff back here. is this? It's another fuel place, I guess. Fixing the service station.
Let's keep Tennessee beautiful.
Four vehicle spare parts for a service station. Okay. I'm surprised there's no viewpoint out here. Really? Well, okay. That wasn't awful. Okay. Well, we made our way through that. Yeah, so it does just loop back around to this. Okay. There's a service hub out there. The heck is that? Is that a trailer? No, that's a truck. There's a truck stuck out there. Okay, this comes back through here, and then there's something up in there, probably connects to this. Well, Alright, so let's recover. Actually, you know what? Let's take this guy. You've heard that chains help with traversing over rocks? They seem to. I can't confirm that firsthand, but they've... when I've had chains on, I've had... It feels like I've had less problems getting over rocks. First things first, let's run this section of track real quick. Make sure there's nothing else out here. Then... come this way. And then I think that leads up here somehow. It would make sense that chains help you get over rocks, because they would in real life. Oh, that's a tire.
Our drivers may not have fancy endorsement deals, but make no mistake, they are world-class
How does that look now? As expected. It's not a lot that actually slows this vehicle down either, which is nice. Up and over that. Okay, so the one thing that slows this thing down is rocks. Big rocks and deep water. But I mean, literally everything else has almost no effect on it whatsoever, which is great. This car's like, what mud? Okay, I've already seen that. I was like, wait, is there another one? Okay, there is a bridge here, which I had not seen before. That's good to know. Nope, don't fall off the edge. I don't want to do that. Awkward ass thing. Well, hell, don't go through there in a regular truck, Jesus. I guess that's why there's a couple of paths around that. All right, look, why? There, do that. It's very interesting how very little in this game will slow this vehicle down, except the things that do slow this vehicle down are quite literally the smallest things. A rock. Boom. Stopped. 6 inches of water. Boom. Stopped. Three feet of mud? No problem. A 6-inch pebble? It's over. I guess we'll finish by getting to the actual place. Okay, that covers that section. There's another section out on the far right. Let's check what this is real quick. Just Just to, like, confirm there's nothing there. Probably. That wouldn't be a bad idea. It looks like they had intended at some point to make another map. It just didn't. Because otherwise, why put a tunnel? Yeah, this snakes around a little bit. Be interested into finding out where they would have taken this. They continued it into a second map. I always wondered what the, in addition to that, I always wondered what the deciding factor was why some maps get one or, like, some expansions get one or two maps, and others get, like, three or four. And initially you would think, well, it has to do with the size of the map. Like, the bigger the map, the less likely you'll have additional ones. But some of the biggest maps are the ones that have four separate areas. And, like, usually two of those maps will be enormous and the other two will be like sized. And it's like, and then you run into Tennessee, which is just a single map, and it's surprisingly small with not a lot in it. I don't understand why they choose that in certain ways, you know what I mean? Very random. Curve! What is this? Is that a Hummer? What are you? Yeah, you're a Hummer. Wow. Adorable. Oh, that's the end. Okay, so I should have come this way. And then to the service station, and then out here. I actually could pick up these trucks and take them back to sell. What's this? There's a tower here. Oh, good Lord. Look at that. Barf. Like an old quarry. This go? Man, there's so much stuff. Okay. Well, that about covers it. There's something back here, and then there's more here. But there's not really much to do other than the main stuff. Like, there's this service station, but... Okay. Alright, I think we're gonna go ahead and call it there for this morning, everybody.